rebounding, typical LeBron James game.
And look, they did not have all their horses. They love what Osman has given them, by the way. Mm-hmm. So great minutes. I'm curious to see with this new group if he's still, LeBron really likes him and the way he plays. 16.6 out of 9. And overall, the King liked the continuity he saw in the win.
Just felt like we played together. Offensively and defensively, the communication was very high. The ball was moving around, the ball was popping, and everybody felt like they was in a good rhythm. So, you know, so this team has played as tough, you know, every single season, no matter their record. They've always played as tough, and I think tonight we finally played them tough and played Cavaliers basketball. No, it's not about what the other guys didn't bring or what these guys bring. I think we're all professionals, and we were, you know, happy with the guys that we had, and we're going to be happy with the guys that we have now. That's the way the league is as a business. So, you know, there's no shade on nobody. We're excited about the new guys that we got coming in, Jordan, Larry, Rodney, and George, and we look forward to them, you know, getting acclimated in this regular season on a high note.
I don't know if it's going to spell a championship, but you cannot do in a day better than what Kobe Altman did yesterday if you're trying to get younger and more athletic, which clearly they did. We mentioned really the only guy with playoff experience being George Hill. Let's talk first about the Laker deal and talk about those guys. And start with Clarkson, who you and I have talked about the minutes he's had this season, especially with Lonzo's out. What does he add to Cleveland?
Well, I love it because he's a young guy. He's played some games, being a young guy with the Lakers, and obviously played a lot last year. So he's got enough experience as far as game time. Playoff experience is totally different. But he has great size. You can switch with him 1, 2, 3. He's athletic enough to get out and run, and he's learned how to play without the basketball with the emergence of Lonzo Ball starting at the point. And then when Lonzo's out, he's been able to flip-flop going back and forth. So I like his approach to the game, the way he's played.
You know, G, I think the most underrated guy in the deal, based on what you hear people talking about, is Larry Nance Jr. Because of the length and the defense and the excitement. And LeBron's been looking for, one of the reasons he likes Osman, that energy and defensive energy. And Nance is a guy who can give that to.
And that's what's been lacking with this team, especially as of late. Energy, hustle, you know, guys that are blue-collar. And Larry Nance, you know, is similar to a Tristan Thompson, different kind of play, but just high energy, going to come in, do the dirty work, going to finish at the rim. Playing hard and playing with effort is a talent. Mm-hmm. And Larry Nance Jr. provides that. So he will, with the theme of getting younger, I like what he does and how it fits with what this team needs.
The upside guy and maybe the biggest unknown who maybe disappoints or gives you is Rodney Hood, who's just loaded with ability and talent, Smitty. We knew he would get moved. Utah knew they wouldn't have him. This is a great move because if LeBron leaves, it's another guy you can have moving forward. What can Hood give them the rest of the way now while they have
him? You have a guy that can flat-out score, and obviously at three levels. He's gotten better at the three-point line. But I like also in spurts, he can create his own. But I think also what he gives is for LeBron James and most of these guys, LeBron was getting a rebound, and he was pushing the basketball, G, and there was four guys always behind him. Now he's going to have four guys that can run in front of him and some guys that can catch lobs and some guys that can spread out and also help him shoot threes. And defensively, they can make a mistake, and these guys, their effort, can clean up that because they're young, they're athletic, and they can get to spots.
All right, let's keep the Hills in the family. Grant, George Hill is a guy who, look, this is a veteran, a savvy guy who knows how to play. That's all you hear people saying. Can he be a factor? Can he give impact to this team maybe more than people are giving credit for?
Well, Casey, you can never go wrong with a G Hill on your team. but I like him and what he does.
Yeah.
You know, he's not a guy that dominates the ball. He's a catch-and-shoot guy. He has experience. He can defend. Had a great year last year in Utah, put up some really big numbers. But I just feel like he complements LeBron James, the type of a player who can hit open shots, can play off of a great player and do that very well. And so, yes, he has experience. He's bounced around, been a part of different teams, obviously, winning championships or winning a championship in San Antonio. But I love that he's a veteran guy, he's experienced, and he's definitely a step up in terms of talent and just complimenting LeBron James from what they've had before at the point guard position.
Well, I'll tell you what, of the guys who left, clearly the toughest one for LeBron to see leave, even though he was happy for him, was Dwayne Wade going back to Wade County. We'll get a look as he puts on that Miami Vice uni for the first time at the reaction he got down in Miami and the reaction he gave with his better half as well. Speaking of which, How about the revenge games? You got a lot of them. You got Blake against his old squad. We'll take a look at that. He looks happy. And this one does, Jimmy Buckets, the Tibbs Bowl back in Chi-Town. We'll look at it all on Game Time. Don't move.